We are at the crossroads, really. We are at the post. Are in the position wherein that we must speak our God. Fear are preventing you from receiving the truth. Fear is preventing the so-called leaders of you today to speak the truth. A leader that is afraid to speak the truth is no leader at all. They all have failed you. Christianity has been the key to your slavery. You have gravely misunderstood that religion. That is a white man's religion. It is not for you and I. There is no salvation in Christianity for black people. It has failed to give you justice. Regardless to your preachers and your church pleading to the government for justice, you get none. Regardless to your prayers to the Father and the Son, you get no justice. Then what good is Christianity to you and I if the religion and the God of that religion will not defend us against lawlessness, against righteousness, against righteousness? We will be fooled to believe and trust such religion and such God that bestows all the blessings of that religion upon our enemies. You have been gravely misled. What you are taught to look forward to for salvation don't even exist there. Christianity offers you salvation after death. And I mean death. You must go down in the earth and rot. Kind of salvation I don't want, I will not give you two cents. Any fool that will work hard all his life praying to God to take him at death and give him a home beyond the grave is a fool. I'm sorry that you think ill of me, but truth is all I'm going to speak. You are in a terrible condition. Without the knowledge of self, God, and the devil and us, you're in a terrible condition. Right in the day of judgment. This is the time of judgment. It is not to come, it's going on now. If it was not already on, I would not be here talking with you this afternoon. the people, numbering between 17 and 20 million people in America, and have worked in slaves for America for 400 long years, only now to be denied justice even by the federal government. We have fought in every war that the country was involved. The so-called Negro blood has been shed on his own soil and on foreign soil, only today to be denied in the government that he has fought and bled and died for. The government allows Lincoln to link you and I at will. And even go so far as to hide the identity of the link. If found by them. Turning the Lincoln over to his brother, who is in sympathy with it. Our daughters and our wives beaten and raped before our eyes by the white man and boys of America. And the government will not put a stop to it, but will allow Lincoln to link you and I if we are charged with an attempt to rape one of them. All of this you suck. The Lincolns live right next door, but is not brought to justice. All of this grief you and I are burdened with. Think over you and I numbering 20 million people approximately in America suffering such shame and humiliation in a rich and a powerful government with its power in the sea, on land, and above the clouds, telling the earth, daring nations to rise their hands at them, and yet will not cut defend you and I. It is injustice in their midst. Is not it high time that you and I get together and find some way for justice for ourselves? We are to continue to suffer such injustice. It is better for you and I to go back home this afternoon and kill our wives, kill our children, and then commit suicide ourselves. Rather than to be caught, 20 million cows. We kill the white man's brother, Germany. We kill other white men's brothers for him. We kill our own brothers